Night mode. Every new camera on our smartphones has to have this feature. But there is something else we use, or used to use. A flash on both our mobile phones and our DSLR.
This photograph over here has a lot in it. Not only did it use one of the earliest electric flashes, it used some techniques which were completely unknown at the time.
This photograph of a drop of milk falling into a cup and creating this crown changed nighttime photography.
If you find this video interesting, remember to subscribe. So dark photography has never really been difficult. In the early days, they used a magnesium ribbon which, when burnt, gives a really bright light as a flash.
There were many other techniques that were developed, but this was the most common one.
In the initial days, photographers traveled with a product called Victor powder, which was a magnesium flare that would become really bright. This, however, was very dangerous, and that led to serious injury and loss of life to some of the photographers.
Then, there was a change. Let's come to this photograph. It will better help in understanding the situation.
The Milk Drop Coronet, taken by Harold Edgerton, circa 1938.
Dr. Harold Edgerton was a scientist from MIT, and he was the first to develop an electronic stroboscope.
A stroboscope is a tube that allows for repeated bursts of light at a regular but brief interval. This tube was filled with xenon by Harold Edgerton.
That tube produced high-intensity bursts of light so short that they were up to 1/1,000,000th of a second. For this particular photograph, Edgerton had an electric dropper that was rigged to his stroboscope and his camera. The milk would fall from the dropper, and at the exact microsecond that it would hit the milk, the strobe light would come out and the photo would be taken.
And this changed the game.
In case you forgot, this was 1932. 7 years before the Second World War, 37 years before man went to the moon, and 89 years before this.
Technology wasn't so advanced yet, yet this man was able to capture such an image. For context, if this was to be done by someone else, it would have taken them a huge budget and a lot of equipment. Probably a room full of just equipment. But this man was special.
This photograph is huge. Not in size, but in impact.
This photo proved that photography could advance human understanding of the physical world.
And it was this technology that laid the foundation for the electric flash.
This photo allowed people to understand what everyday occurrences actually look like.
As one article put it, it allowed for the artful freezing of fragments of time.
This also laid another foundation, the foundation for high-speed photography.
You've probably seen a sports game, and probably seen some sports photographs of your favorite players. These were taken using very high shutter speeds, which is the amount of time that the shutter of the camera opens to allow light to come in.
Most of the cameras that we have at home shoot up to 4,000 or 6,000th of a second.
This photograph was taken at a speed of 10,000th of a second, and the light came on for 1/1,000,000th of a second. Just imagine the precision on that.
As one colleague of Edgerton put it, it's a matter of 1,000th of a second, and the right 1,000th of a second to get that crown. Isn't that insane?
Harold Edgerton would go on to do so many things in his life, but somehow everything was related to this.
In World War II, he helped American fighter jets illuminate enemy targets on night missions.
And do you see the flashing lights on police cars? Well, that's another thing that he improved.
But this photograph is an artifact. Even though Edgerton took many other high-speed photographs like glass breaking or the bullet being shot, this photograph was one of his most famous and influential works.
In fact, this photo was featured in the Time magazine 100 Most Influential Photographs.
And as we like to say, technology will get better in the future. The changes made by us and the people after us will always be huge. But we must remember where we started from and appreciate where we are now.